Welcome to St. Patrick's Cathedral for this office of evening prayer of the second Friday in Lent. O Lord, open thou our lips, and our mouths shall show forth thy praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise ye the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. Proper to Day 26, Evening Prayer, a portion of Psalm 119, verses 169 to the end. Let my complaint come before thee, O Lord. Give me understanding according to thy word. Let my supplication come before thee. Deliver me according to thy word. My lips shall speak of thy praise. When thou hast taught me thy statutes, yea, my tongue shall sing of thy word. For all thy commandments are righteous. Let thy hand help me. For I have chosen thy commandments. I have longed for thy saving health, O Lord. And in thy law is my delight. Let my soul live, and it shall praise thee. And thy judgments shall help me. I have gone astray like a sheep that is lost. O seek thy servant, for I do not forget thy commandments. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The lesson is written in the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, in chapter 4, at verse 1. What are we to say about Abraham, our ancestor in the natural line? If Abraham was justified by anything he had done, then he has a ground for pride. But he has no such ground before God. For what does Scripture say? Abraham put his faith in God, and that faith was counted to him as righteousness. Now, if a man does a piece of work, his wages are not counted as a favour, they are paid as debt. But if without any work to his credit, he simply puts his faith in him who acquits the guilty, then this man is indeed counted as righteousness. In the same sense, David speaks of the happiness of the man whom God counts as just, apart from any specific acts of justice. Happy are they, he says, whose lawless deeds are forgiven, whose sins are buried away. Happy is the one whose sins the Lord does not count against him. Here endeth the lesson. The Gospel Canticle is Magnificat, the song of the Blessed Virgin Mary. My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Saviour, for he hath regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. For behold, from henceforth all generation shall call me blessed, for he that is mighty hath magnified me, and holy is his name, and his mercy is on them that fear him. Throughout all generations he hath showed strength with his arm. He hath scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He hath put down the mighty from their seat, and hath exalted the humble and meek. He hath filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he hath sent empty away. He, remembering his mercy, hath helped his servant Israel, as he promised to our forefathers, Abraham and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with thy spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. O Lord, show thy mercy upon us, and grant us thy salvation. O Lord, guide and defend our rulers, and mercifully hear us when we call upon thee. Endue thy ministers with righteousness, and make thy chosen people joyful. O Lord, save thy people, and bless thine inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, because there is none other that fighteth for us, but only thou, O God. O God, make clean our hearts within us, and take not thy Holy Spirit from us. O Lord, who for our sake didst fast 40 days and 40 nights, give us grace to use such abstinence that, our flesh being subdued to the Spirit, we may ever obey thy godly motions in righteousness and true holiness, to thine honour and glory, who livest and reignest with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen. O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, Give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Saviour. Amen. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. On Fridays we think of the cross, where Jesus died for your sins and for mine on Good Friday. Almighty God, who in the passion of your blessed Son made the instrument of shameful death to be for us the means of life, grant us so to glory in the cross of Christ that we may gladly suffer for his sake, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for ever. Amen. We continue to bring before God our own needs and the needs of those who have asked us to pray for them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me, a sinner. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. The Lord be with you and with thy spirit. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May the souls of the faithful, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.